Welcome everyone to Getting Off Track. I'm Taco Cat, WFTDA Board of Directors member, and you're watching the WFTDA Roller Derby Extraordinaire Twitch channel, whatever that means. Really excited because today I'm being joined by Greta Turbo of Gotham Girls Roller Derby, who's spearheading a lot of Gotham's digital activities these days. Greta is also one of the longest skating people I know, and I've also skated with her, so I'm really excited to catch up and hear some of Greta's stories. First, I'd like to share some WFTDA updates, in particular about something that's happening this Friday. You can learn more about going to WFTDA.com, but our annual meeting is Friday and Saturday for WFTDA member leagues, and our Friday is a sort of State of the Nation address at 4 p.m. Eastern, and it's just us coming to you and letting you know what's going on right now with the WFTDA and Roller Derby. And later in that weekend, we'll also be releasing our return to play plan about what happens when Derby returns. So please get some more info on that. Make sure your league mates know, and you can watch the state of the WFTDA on Facebook Live this Friday. All right, so let's go. Our first guest is Greta Turbo from Gotham Girls Roller Derby, who I feel can do a much better job of introducing herself than I can.
Oh my goodness. Yeah. My derby timeline is a little strange. I started back in December of 2004. I was not the first group that started with Gotham. I was like that first like official class that had to try out. Well, I don't even know if I had to try out. Probably not, because I could not skate. I never skated before skating derby at all, and all of my sports past were like hand-eye coordination sports, so I like came with like literally no toolkit. And then I skated for 7 years. I was one of the original members of the Queens of Pain, and then retired in 2011, and then speed skated for like a minute, and then joined GSR in, what year was that, like 2015, I guess? 16?
I think
whatever
so.
Happened, the whole world had changed. Like, nothing made sense.
I think it was 2015.
yeah, nothing made sense.
That's when you and I were teammates.
Exactly. There were no minors. I was like, what happened to the minors? There were no, like, I think we had just gotten rid of two whistles. Like, there were knee starts right before I retired, so, like, no. If there were knee starts, then we still had two whistles. I mean, basically, like, the whole game had completely changed. Everybody was skating backwards. I suddenly was like, oh, I have to do this now. And so it took me, like, a good 2 or 3 years to feel like I actually could play again. And then, magically, I ended up back with Gotham. So so now I am one of the, with a gap, the longest, I guess, serving Gotham people of the league at the moment, even though I still am like, I don't totally know everybody yet. I'm working on it.
You've seen everything with roller derby, and you're even seeing what's going on right now. Can't imagine what that's like.
Oh God. Well, because like right before I left, we had been creating for a couple of years. Well, video committee before I took over, and I want to say like 2008, was like basically just coaching cuts. It was nothing. It was like coaching cuts and the occasional like end of year montage. And then all of a sudden I'm like, well, maybe we can use this to learn from our mistakes and fouls and stuff. And so I started filming things and just, you know, putting them on DVDs, like double layer DVDs. And our coaching cuts became like these multi-angle, like, you know how you could change angles with the DVDs of your, like, you could like decide what camera you wanted to look at. So we would put like four cameras on a game, and I would literally manually cut those together into multi-layer, like dual layer DVDs. And then that was the coaching cut. And then somehow one of the people who came into Gotham, Steel Magnolia, who had a film production like background, actually she was GSR, I believe, before she went to Gotham as well, like way back. And she's like, I think we could do a show. And we approached like NYC Life, which was like a New York Public Access. And then for about, I think, 3 years, we had this show, this public access show. And like, we literally created, and it was the first episode of our Twitch channel, actually, where we like literally showed one of these old episodes where we had segments that we filmed. We had like often very terrible green screen, and like, which made it look like Dr. Katz with like the crazy, like, swimmy lines and stuff like that. We had, we had so many different like variations of like throwing things at the wall and seeing what stuck. And like, but we ended up with like, you know, a bunch of episodes of this show that ended up showing on public access for many years after we were creating the show. So like, it would be 3 a.m. and you would turn on public access and then you would suddenly see Gotham from 2009 skating like the same game you've probably seen a billion times before. And like, and that was kind of how I left, was like, that was still going. And then I retired, and then now I come back, and the first thing I noticed is that the current video committee person was retiring. I saw the asterisk next to her name, and okay, I was like, I see what's happening now.
I see what's happening. I know you're not a gamer. How did you end up on Twitch for all things video production right now and content?
Okay. So coming back into video committee, it changed a bit. Like at the time it was mostly, again, back to coaching cuts and putting things on YouTube and like making a much simpler affair. And I was all for that. I was like, yeah, the thought of doing anything quite as labor intensive as creating a public access show was giving me like hives. But in the back of my head, I was like, maybe there's something that we can do to help video kind of become its like own little self-fulfilling engine. So like, whether or not it was like paying for itself, but at least it was kind of sustaining itself somehow. And I kind of put that in the back of my head, and I actually contacted Ben from Quad Media and WFTDA, and was like, how are you doing this? Because I remembered there were like a couple of snafus with the whole ESPN thing. I didn't really know everything about it, but I knew that there was stuff. I knew that Twitch was kind of where things were landing now. And I'm like, how can we use that in a way that is kind of symbiotic with WFTDA's like umbrella? Like, I had this dream of potentially having kind of like an NPR PBS, where like WFTDA is PBS and we're like WNJ whatever, and like we're the, just a subsidiary that's making content, but we all can kind of like coexist in the same sphere, much like the leagues do with the with WFTDA in general. And so like, I called up Ben. I'm like, what's going on? This is well before there was any virus potential. And like, we had this amazing chat, and it turned out that he had been thinking about the exact same thing. Like, it was just, it just made sense, because why isn't there Derby available to watch all the time? If we have this many leagues in the world, why can't every league have some sort of semblance of an existence on Twitch? Because Twitch is really getting interested in sports. Why not take advantage of that? Unfortunately, Twitch's language of operation is still very gamey, which is a little tricky for my 41-year-old brain that still is like all about Tetris and Donkey Kong to like totally understand. But at the same time, I'm like loving kind of diving in and learning. And now that Gotham is so much bigger than it was when I left, there are a lot more people who can take the other roles. Like, video committee back when I was doing it the first time was like 5 people. And we were all dying. And most of the people on it were not actual skaters. And now it's kind of like a whole bunch of people happen to have like motion graphics experience, or they have PR experience, or they have social media producing experience, or they're just really good at shooting. I mean, and like, it's a whole different world now.
So what kinds of things are you showing on the Gotham Twitch channel? I saw there was a skate tutorial. I saw there's some watch parties. Can you tell us a little bit more about that?
Yeah. Maybe I should back up to when the virus happened and why we just suddenly decided to launch a Twitch right then and there. Before we had a plan for anything, I think our game was going to be the weekend they started rumbling about the potentiality that New York would have to kind of shut down. And it started becoming clear that if not LAU, I forget the venue that we were in, I think John Jay, if John Jay wasn't having classes, which was going to be the venue for the game, then we were kind of putting two and two together that they might not be able to have, like, with no official word yet, that they might not be able to actually host the game. So suddenly I'm like, uh-oh, need to get this together, like, now, because there is this possibility that we might still play, but we might have to play in Crashpad and live stream it for ticket holders. How in the heck do we do this? Can we still actually charge? Can we, like, what, you know, all the questions that go through. So I just suddenly had to get a crash course in it. And then by the time that game, we just decided it was a bad idea. And like the stop all derbying happened that happened everywhere. It was like, well, now we have this channel. Why don't we just start putting things up? Because at least we can start growing an audience, you know, keep people engaged. And we just so happen to have fully formed packaged little nuggets of vintage derby that we made back in 2009, 2010. And so that's how it started. Because I just happened to pick a game where I lapped Bonnie Thunders as a jammer. I just happened to pick that game. Queens lost, but this was my unicorn moment. I was going to keep it. And I asked Susie to come and Bunny, Beatrix Slaughter, who all three of us had been in that game, and a like very, very new to derby skater who I wanted to see like her reaction to how weird old derby looks in comparison to what it looks like now. And then we also had Kate Sarasara, who was helpful, like kind of like co-piloting, because I had to like run that stream. But I was so afraid of something going wrong that I wanted to have the one other person who knew everything about it, which is Kate, and like kind of as my like Spock. So that's how that started, and that's how that became the pilot. And like old derby players from like who I hadn't heard about for over 10 years suddenly were appearing on the Twitch chat. And I'm like, this is great. Maybe we can kind of keep this momentum going and like hopefully bring in all of the kind of older derby skaters. And then after that, bring in maybe people from outside the Gotham universe. And then maybe beyond that, bring people who just want to watch interesting sports because there are no sports. And so then the programming started to balloon into all these different things that we could potentially try out, much like what I kind of can tell is happening with WFTDA's channel as well. And so as a result, some interesting things happen. Like yesterday we had a mask making crafty thing, with, a couple of the more crafty, skaters. I am not one of them. And right now we're also hosting kind of a partnership with, Five Stride, where they are going into depth on certain like skate related topics. Like I think this Wednesday is going to be protective gear, and last week was all about outdoor wheels, and that's going to be a regular thing. And then we have like a bunch of other stuff. Like we're going to be putting a juniors game up. We're going to be doing a broadcast in Spanish. We are doing a whole bunch of stuff that is like, you know, we're trying everything and different time slots and all that good stuff.
And I mean, I know here at the WFTDA, we're running out of puns to name things. It's like, how many times can you say, talk derby to me?
Yeah,
and not that I mean, I love it. It's perfect, but
yeah,
you know. So, well, for example, the WTDA, we were going to do a board of directors update, and we were going to call it the Bodcast instead of podcast. And it's just, you know, we're getting to that point. So how are you coming up with names, and maybe what are some of your rejections?
Oh, we're failing. We're failing miserably. I mean, the one that I am going to ride, I'm going to ride this horse as long as everybody will let me, is that I want to call our rewatch parties Gotham Now, where we watch things that happened then and show them to you now. And I wanted to actually do a whole like, packaging to make it like the documentary now packaging. So stay tuned. This could happen, that we could have people introducing the old games, like Helen Mirren, like telling you what to expect. Because if we put on the very first game Gotham ever played, y'all gonna be very confused. because nothing is going to look like anything you recognize as derby. It's going to look basically like a foot race on wheels, and it's kind of hilarious.
Oh my gosh.
And there's like tackles and stuff. So we figured comedically putting those things in context, but we also accidentally, and I'm very sorry, took the name basically of this show and used it for our show yesterday because we couldn't figure out what to call a crafting show or a DIY show or things that would have multiple episodes. So it became Gotham Off the Track. And then I look at the email to come on this and I was like, oh man, I knew that was too close to something. Well, damn it. So yeah, we're going to have to come up with a new one for that because y'all had it first. No, you had it first. I mean,
it's okay.
It's very important to me.
Yeah. Well, thank you. I mean, we do you guys. No.
But like we're trying, I mean, the names are the worst because I don't like to write copy. It's not what I like to do. So I usually leave that to other people. And I'm trying to think about like other things that have just been, I mean, our spitballing is not exactly like poetic. It's just what puns can be possibly put together in a way that's going to make it sound like something that people would want to watch. So Five Stride is Five Stride Live. They came up with that one. How many things live can you have?
To the point.
Yeah, exactly. So, yeah,
I mean,
Gotham
loves a
Five Stride Live. Yeah, exactly.
It's very explanatory. So, I mean, Gotham has the benefit of being in a major city and having so many awesome people, right? The bigger cities, mm-hmm. more people come to them. What do you think makes Gotham like the perfect league to be doing this Twitch experiment?
Well, I don't know if it's because Gotham is the perfect league or, I mean, this is going to sound egotistical, but like, honestly, I don't think this would be happening necessarily if I wasn't literally like watching it happen. Like, I don't know if anybody existing in the league would have just decided to go full force into this. And the only reason I wanted to is because I had done it already. If I hadn't done it already, I wouldn't want to do it either. Like, I would be, this is nuts, this is too much. But like, I do think it's just kind of kismet that I just happened to have gotten back into the league at this moment. And I happen to have the gear knowledge and like, because we, this is another fun fact. We had a Twitch, we had a switcher from Black Magic that wasn't even on the market yet, which was a prototype.
What is a switcher?
Like a live switcher, similar to what's happening behind the scenes now. Hi, Ben.
Okay.
So but like a that button. Is literally like, yeah, buttons. Like it's almost like having a big keyboard. And there's like a big just metal box with like holes that you plug things into. And there's like a big heat sink that's like epoxied to the outside because like this thing is just ancient and was never actually on the market. But we had a Black Magic sponsorship back then because Steel Magnolia made it happen. I mean, that's what I'm saying. Like we were lucky back then too. We had someone who was already in the production world. So I had this switcher that so the first thing that happens when I come back into Gotham is that one of the NSOs comes up to me and is like, can you figure out how to put the scoreboard on the scrimmages? And I was like, and so it begins. I'm immediately getting asked to do things. And so I was like, because like literally I was working like 60, I mean, to do that public access show, I was putting in well over a full-time job worth of hours and skating and trying to work at the same time. So it was a lot. And it was just because there was no one to spread the work out to. So now we have the switcher that was like, I think at this point, 13 years old, out on a desk. And me and Kate Sarasara, who literally is like, without Kate, this would not be happening. Kate is also like a key ingredient to this because she knows all of this kind of back end. Like she's a great troubleshooter. She understands like in and outs and all that kind of stuff and like the engineering side of things. And so we basically like troubleshot this thing for like 4 or 5 days until we got it right. And then suddenly one scrimmage, there's a scoreboard that appears on the video when it goes up to YouTube and everybody's like, whoa. And then it's like, we're also doing it on a Mac tower that I think at this point is also 12 years old. Like an old Mac tower that was sitting in Crash Pad as a glorified printing station. and then change that. Like, so we're taking all the stuff that was used back in 2010 and reusing it now for what we're doing. So yeah.
Derby warehouses and derby practice spaces kind of become this mm-hmm. place that skaters and people like bring things to and then forget about, you know, it's
yep.
kind of, so it's cool that those things are being used rather than just sitting there and collecting dust.
Well, like, I mean, they were used for a while, but then after a while, there wasn't a reason to, I mean, we would literally like build the whole scaffolding, put the switcher underneath, put two camera people up at the top, like do all of these things. Like the production video alone was a full, like while everybody else was setting up the track, we were doing that, you know? So it's like,
yeah,
it was a big part of it. Mm-hmm. And I mean, you know this from yeah. the tournaments, because like pretty much what you do at the tournaments mm-hmm. is exactly what we were doing on the local level when we were producing that show.
Yeah. It takes a lot of people, a lot of running around, mm-hmm. a lot of wires to not trip over, but
true.
So true. outside of Twitch and what the league is doing for everyone socially, mm-hmm. what is Gotham doing internally for the league just to stay together, to kind of keep that camaraderie going? And what's that been like?
Lots of Zoom workouts. Let's just put, like every day of the week, there's probably a Zoom workout happening. There's been, you know, people rewatching footage there. One of the skaters has been leading kind of a jam skating class, which has been fantastic, kind of building off the like skate aerobics thing, which is happening as well, which is, please check it out if you want to figure out how to dance in a small space. Skate aerobics is pretty great. That is not the Gotham thing. This is just me speaking for myself. You know, I think like we've been doing the Twitch has been helping, because it's been making people engaged in, you know, something different that I think might be just helping to break up the monotony in a way, because the kind of energy, the amazing amount of energy that skaters put into bout production or game production is now finding a new way to come out. But at the same time, we're able to spotlight and highlight skaters that maybe don't get quite as much attention, you know, just because they just don't, because we're finding different aspects of the league to highlight while still keeping it very much on target, you know, like, and so I think that pretty much everything helps, like creating social media videos. We just finished a fundraiser that was very successful. You know, like it's hard. I'm again speaking again for myself, because I don't want to like put words in anybody else's mouth. It's hard. Like, I think there are kind of two kinds of people right now, and they're the people who like can't motivate themselves to kind of work out, and the people who are like working out all the time, like because it's like we don't have that physical release. And in my case, I've been binge watching the Stabler Years of SVU and doing like two workouts a night. I've been like watching the Cynthia Rothrock YouTube channel. There's all sorts of things that people are doing, I think, to keep themselves like kind of sane in the within like the Gotham universe and kind of like in the Gotham extended universe.
The Gotham extended universe.
Gotham extended universe. I mean, I watched Age of Ultron the other day, so I had that in the back of my head for a while.
Yeah. So let's see. We have some Twitch comments. What's a DVD?
You're kidding. Oh my goodness.
No, it's there.
That has got to be
there.
Okay.
Oh, I love
well,
it.
Back in
Derby from the Balcony. Yeah. Derby from the Balcony says they used to watch Gotham on Instagram, if they remember correctly.
On Instagram?
Let's see. Yeah. PDX Speedbump is saying that the first Gotham Twitch stream was intense. 300 fans came and watched. That's pretty good.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, no, it was really, really great. And like a lot of the kind of old timers, as it were suddenly back in play and like had, you know, their own little anecdotes to add. It was really great. It was a really awesome experience.
Yeah. I mean, I love that. I love it when retired skaters come back, especially from this era, from the beginning of Derby. Mm-hmm. Anyway, so speaking of retired skaters and beginning of Derby, let's do some Derby show and tell. Okay. Do you have any interesting roller derby related items where you're sitting?
Yeah, actually, right where I'm sitting. This is the one of the original. I don't know if this is the original or just like one of the original Gotham Girls shirts. I've got two of them. This is before we actually had a logo. So this was, I guess, sort of the logo. And it's like, you know, kind of, it's very like vintage 60s looking. Yeah, so this is an absolute original shirt that I've had for, damn, 16 years, 17, jeez. Yeah, long time. Like house is like, this apartment is just full of random like relics, because I kept my original Queens jersey. I kept my bearing necklace with the three bearings that we won when I was still there. Like, I mean, there's a bunch of stuff. And then behind me is this mannequin that gets dressed up in various outfits that are derby related as a backdrop to whenever I have to stream. So always look for that. It's going to change periodically. Yeah, it's there's definitely a lot of show and tell though.
We should just do like a show and tell hour at another point.
Great idea for a show.
I know. So yeah. I decided if I was going to ask you, then I guess I would pull something out, and I don't really have much here. It's mostly back home in New Jersey. I have a poster from, that's a glare. The last game I played before my injury that kind of ended my competitive career. So that really stunk, but like, I'm glad I grabbed this poster because I can remember the date.
Nice. That's so, yeah, so this cool.
It says Stronger Things. This is a tournament that they play out in Lille in France. Oh my gosh, that light. And yeah, so
no, that's my, really
my
cute.
Derby show and tell today. Yeah.
Nice. Nice. If I had thought about it, I would have grabbed, like, there's so much stuff in the other room, like just my original sash, my original, like I have so much stuff.
Oh my God. Yeah. Okay, wait, can I ask you to show us one more thing?
Sure.
just grab something, anything. One more thing. So you grab that.
You're going to have to see like the fact that my pants don't match my shirt. So just hold on.
I mean, hey, at least
you can switch away.
Pants.
You can be respectful and switch away from me right now. Okay.
Yeah, Ben, you can switch the camera over. Time out for a sec.
Okay.
No, wrong way. See, that's what makes it fun. I mean, I put pants on, like real pants on for the thrill of it earlier this week, and it was great. Like I had a belt on and everything. Anyway, so while we wait for Greta to come back, you know, you could follow us on Twitch by clicking the heart. You can subscribe to our YouTube channel to see what else we're up to. There's plenty of other shows going on, and you know, we're excited that you're here to join us. I know we all miss Derby desperately. I miss seeing people. I miss the smell. So
really, do you?
It's weird. It's just this funk.
It is a very specific funk that exists nowhere else in nature and shouldn't. But yeah, it is one of those things. Like there is definitely a nostalgia that comes along with it. But anyway, I have my thing, which is the corset that the original Queens skaters had to wear. It's basically, it was a cloth corset, and we would wear it over our uniform. And like, you know, you can see all the grommets that fell off and whatnot. Because the original uniforms were handmade. Although we wore a lot of, Queens specifically wore a lot more American apparel and a lot less handmade stuff. But this was the one really handmade element of the whole equation.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Oh, that's great.
But yeah. Yeah. And that was just the easiest one to grab when I went in the other room.
That's pretty good.
There's like tons of stuff. Like we had one of our original derby taunts was at the very long gone Siberia bar. And we had dance cards, so you could like dance with the Derby girl, and like I still have that. I still have all sorts of just bizarre stuff. I have hard drives full of games. I have all the mini, like, you know, mini DVD, like, you know, the digital archive too is very deep.
Oh wow.
Yeah, it's great. I mean, like we're a very well documented league. So if a game was played, we probably have a record of it somewhere.
That's pretty good. I mean, I love all that stuff, that ephemera. Well, thank you for sharing. I guess I don't know. I'm reading Slam, the second
Oh,
one. I just got this.
neat. Are
Yeah,
you doing the
so that's
book
what I'm up
corner? Is
to.
that thing happening? I know you were like
No, that's
talking
one
about
of our other
potentially.
Twitch shows. Yeah, I
Cool.
think Chloroform Cupcake, I think, is doing the book club. I think they just did
Awesome.
Roller Girl by Victoria Jameson, and I know Jameson was on the interview, which is pretty cool. So yeah, we're also trying all sorts of different things
Yeah,
over
have
here.
you
So
experimented with the Twitch watch yet? Because that's like the next thing that we're kind of looking into.
yeah, I think so. That's a Ben question. I don't
Yeah,
watch
no,
all
it's
the
a
shows, but
no. This is a
yeah.
very like it's a very specific thing that just started because like, if there's like a book club, then it kind of stands that, there's tons of like skating movies and there's tons of sports movies in general and things like that. And then like magic, Amazon
Yeah.
launches Twitch like they're because they're connected. They have a way that you can actually do Twitch watch parties where you can actually watch anything that's on Prime and like have the same interface that you would like with the chatting and all that
Oh,
stuff, but you're
cool.
actually like
Oh, I didn't know
literally
that.
allowed to like watch a real movie online
Yeah.
legally without a problem. Yeah, it's pretty great.
Okay, so I see Ben says there's a Twitch watch party Monday afternoon with Star Trek. I think Star
Oh.
Trek, like the actual show, not like a person named Star Trek.
Well, like So the, is it, it which season or is the wait is it a movie or the TV show? Which one?
I'm not sure. I'm sure Ben will let you know.
Oh my God, I'm so curious. I'm gonna have to watch this. But yeah, because like
So this is
it is interesting.
pretty
We have to make up original content, but then Amazon just made it really easy for us to like wiggle in, some more other stuff that's derby related.
Yeah, it's useful. So Greta, thank you so much for joining us. If people want to find you in all things Gotham, where can they go?
I am less easy to find than Gotham is. Greta Turbo is my moniker, and I do kind of hold true to that introverted way of things. But you can follow Gotham's Twitch at Gotham Roller Derby, twitch.tv/GothamRollerDerby. And me personally, God, there really is no good one. I used to have a really nice Instagram of the free cycle in my laundry room, but because they had to disable the free cycle for COVID, there's nothing really going on
Oh.
there. But you will definitely see me on a number of streams popping up, especially if things go awry and I have to like suddenly do like some engineering, like happened
Yeah.
with a recent one. And I'm definitely going to be on a couple things like coming up. But yeah, no, I'm super, super excited to be working on this and really excited to talk to you because it's been a while.
I know it has been a while. So this was great. I'm glad we got to catch up, and I'm glad that everyone joined us on our little Twitch show here. Thank you so much for joining us, Greta.
No problem. Thank you for having me.
Right, so that wraps up our fifth episode of Getting Off Track. When we originally came up with this show, we wanted it to be a lot more live derby, but of course things happen. So if you have any ideas or comments, you can chat with us or drop us a comment. And we'll see you next week, or maybe in 2 weeks. I'm Taco Cat. Thanks for watching.